He has outsoared the shadow of our nights. Envy and calumny and hate and pain and that unrest which men miscall delight can touch him not and torture not again. From the contagion of the world's slow stain, he is secure and now can never mourn a heart grown cold, a head grown gray in vain. Nor when the spirit self has ceased to burn, with sparkless ashes load an unlamented urn. He lives, he wakes, his death is dead, not he. Mourn not for Adonais. Thou young dawn, turn all thy dew to splendor, for from thee the spirit thou lamentest is not gone. Ye caverns and ye forests, cease to moan. Cease, ye faint flowers and fountains, and thou air, which like a mourning veil thy scarf had thrown o'er the abandoned earth, now leave it bare, even to the joyous stars which smile on its despair. He is made one with nature. There is heard his voice in all her music, from the moan of thunder to the song of night's sweet bird. He is a presence to be felt and known in darkness and in light from herb and stone, spreading itself where'er that power may move, which has withdrawn his being to its own, which wields the world with never-wearied love, sustains it from beneath and kindles it above. He is a portion of the loveliness which once he made more lovely. He doth bear his part, while the one spirit's plastic stress sweeps through the dull, dense world, compelling there all new successions to the forms they wear, torturing the unwilling dross that checks its flight to its own likeness, as each mass may bear, and bursting in its beauty and its might from trees and beasts and men into the heaven's light. The one remains, the many change and pass. Heaven's light forever shines, earth's shadows fly. Life, like a dome of many-colored glass, stains the white radiance of eternity until death tramples it to fragments. Die if thou wouldst be with that which thou dost see. Follow where all is fled. Rome's azure sky, flowers, ruins, statue, music, words are weak. The glory they transfuse with fitting truth to speak. The breath whose might I have invoked in song descends on me. My spirit's bark is driven far, far from the shore, far from the trembling throng whose sails were never to the tempest given. The massy earth and spherid skies are riven. I am borne darkly, fearfully afar, whilst burning through the inmost veil of heaven. The soul of Adonais, like a star, beacons from the abode where the eternal